Hey, it's Project Lead here to show you how to create multiple sheets in Revit with no add-ins. It's much easier than you think, so stay tuned for this short tutorial.
So today's agenda is what you need and how to do it. So what you need is a sheet family loaded in the project, a list of instance parameters you would like to set for each sheet. So I'm going to just go with sheet number, sheet name, designed by, drawn by, checked by, approved by. Really easy. You can see a little example here on the right hand side. How to do it? We can go through these 14 steps and we'll go through one at a time. Thanks, and let's get started. So what we're going to do first is we're going to go to the Schedules tab under the project browser. We're going to right click. We're going to go to New Sheet List. I'm going to choose the instance base parameters that we selected previously. We're going to go sheet number. We're going to do that first. Name. And what we want to do is designed by, drawn by, checked by, and approved by. Those are the ones that we're going to be using for today's tutorial. Click OK, and then you've got your list. Now that we've got a list, we can just see what sheets we have currently in our project. As you can see here, that's not exactly groundbreaking. So what we're going to do next is we're going to click on the sheet that's closest to the number that we want to start with creating. Right now, we just want to start with A3. So right, what I'm going to do is I'm going to change this to A3, and then I'm going to just change it back. I'll tell you why in a second. The reason why we're going to be doing this is because Revit will remember the last sheet number edited, and we can continue from there. When we go back into the sheet list and we go to Modify tab, and we go to Rows panel and Insert New Rows, and see it starts from A3 because the last edited number was A2. So you can just go and add a few sheets here. You can add as many as you like, and these will be your placeholder sheets. All you need to do now is fill in this data, and then we'll go and create the sheets. Now that we have our sheet list together with our parameters filled in, we can go over to the Modify tab and the Create panel and click on New Sheet. What we'll see is all of those new sheets under the placeholder sheets. We can select them, select multiple. What we'll do now is we'll select which title block we're going to use, and I'll just choose the A1 metric, which is standard for us in Australia, and I'll select OK. And as you can see, all of the multiple sheets have been created, and now that is the real treat of having this set up. Don't need any add-ins, and it's going to save you a ton of time. As you can see, the sheet has been created with the correct number assigned to it, as well as the correct title. You can see here on the left, it's A3 elevations, and then it's exactly what we have wanted, and I've assigned project lead, and that is about it. So as you can see, this is working exactly the way I expected.
Of course, you have to ask yourself, what are the limitations of this? And you can see it, you probably want to add like 10 to 15 sheets at a time, and you'd end up with having to add in a lot of parameters manually on Revit, which is probably not ideal. So you might want to look into Dynamo to add in more sheets than just your 10 to 15, or you can look into PyRevit or DRoots. However, this method is perfect for those few sheets that you just want to add in relatively quickly. So I'd highly recommend this method. If you like this video, I recommend that you check out some of my other Revit hacks over here. Remember to like this video and subscribe for more content like this. All supporting documentation links can be found in the description below. And if you're feeling up to it, I'd really appreciate your support over on Ko-fi. Happy designing!